I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Good morning, game fackers. This is your boy, the Slime Man, speaking to you with my voice and just bringing you this nasty movie review.
Why are you so nasty?
Today, I'm going to be reviewing Godzilla, King of the Monsters. And I have to tell you, this movie is so good. Now, before we start, I have to say, this will have spoilers. I mean, we all love spoilers. Well, except for a few. So just putting it out there, there will be spoilers. Enough said. So first, I want to say that I liked the 2014 Godzilla movie. It was alright. I mean, it wasn't perfect. I mean, my biggest gripe with it was how, and pretty much this is everyone's gripe, how the monster action was put in the back burner. It's like whenever an action scene would start, it would just cut away and go back to human stuff. Pretty much that really irked me the wrong way. That was my only irk about that movie. I hated that stuff. Now, I'm sure most of you have heard that that has been pretty much remedied for the most part for this new movie. And I agree, there's a lot more action. And this time, it doesn't really cut. I mean, they actually show the monster battles, which is pretty much what we want to see in a Godzilla movie, at least from most Godzilla fans. Now, I went to an 11 a.m. show, and the theater was pretty, well, it was about half full, I would say. What surprised me is there were a lot of older people, like senior citizens, in the theater. And I was sitting behind this one couple, and it was so cool. They were talking about classic Godzilla movies. The lady was pretty knowledgeable. I mean, she started talking about monsters like Hedorah and Megalon, Gigan. So she knew her stuff. And she was about, oh, I don't know, I'm going to take a guess. She was probably about 60? So that was pretty cool. I found it cool. Now, the movie starts off kind of slow, I have to admit. I was kind of bored, actually, for the first, 30 minutes. Pretty much it focused. And I mean, I get it. They have to set up the story and kind of catch you up on what happened, I guess, in the 2014 movie. But it just felt kind of slow to me. Once the monsters came onto the scene and were released, then the movie really picked up. I was so interested. And right off the bat, I'm going to say Rodan just steals the show. I mean, he has limited time on screen, but when he's on screen, he's just so cool. And pretty much all the monsters have these personalities now. They're so different, so unique. And I just love Rodan. I mean, I've always been a fan of his, but I just love how they treated him in this film. Godzilla is still big, mean, unstoppable. His presence is so amazing. I mean, when he shows up, you know stuff is gonna get destroyed, for sure. King Ghidorah, he was so menacing. I just love the way they made him look. I mean, his three heads, each one having unique personalities, and just how large he was. I mean, with his wingspans opened, he was so huge, much bigger than Godzilla. I mean, Godzilla looked pretty small compared to him. And then we have Mothra. I mean, they really did a great job with her. Her backstory, they covered that, pretty much, I would say. And they gave her quite a unique storyline. She's like a protector, a healer, the peacemaker of the monsters. And I guess she's always been that. But in this movie, they really show it really well. Like I said, the monster battles are so amazing. I mean, once those monsters get released, the movie really picks up, and I really didn't feel like a two-hour movie. I mean, the action was smooth. I felt it was really well paced, and I was really entertained. My favorite battle? Well, it would have to be Rodan when he first gets released. And how he destroys this town, it was so amazing. I mean, I just love the effects, how Rodan took on these jets, how he destroyed them, doing these barrel rolls, dives, and he just looked so cool. And the battle between Rodan and Mothra was pretty awesome as well. I mean, I wish it would have been longer, but what was shown was pretty cool. Even though my boy Rodan lost. But that was kind of expected. I mean, Mothra, she just has to come out on top. I also like how they created these new other new monsters. Like this giant mammoth monster. He looked pretty cool. I mean, we saw some video of him like on a TV screen. So they didn't show too much. There was also this large spider monster, which looked pretty cool. And it looked like at one point, they had a new Muto monster. From the first movie, those insect-like monsters. The final battle between King Ghidorah and Godzilla was just so epic, amazing. I loved how Godzilla became Burning Godzilla. And he had these amazing fire powers. Like he, instead of releasing like fire breath, he used these pulses which he generated, and that's pretty much how he defeated Ghidorah, by using these energy heat pulses. So that was pretty cool. Now I like the human characters pretty well for the most part, except for one who kind of irked me the wrong way, Vera Farmiga's character. She came off as a Thanos type character just due to her ideology about freeing the monsters and bringing balance, some weird theory about balance to the world. It was just so weird. It didn't really make sense to me at all. And at the end, when she quote sacrifices herself, it just didn't feel like she redeemed herself. I mean, how many people died because she released Rodan and King Ghidorah? It just didn't sit well with me. But for the most part, all the other characters, the other human characters, did a pretty good job. Now, I've been a huge Godzilla fan for many years. For a long time, my favorite Godzilla movie was Tokyo SOS, pretty much because I'm a Mecha Godzilla fan. But this one, King of the Monsters, is just up there so high. It's just so well done. The audience that I saw the movie with was so into it. I mean, they were cheering, they were applauding. It was such a good experience. You should definitely go see it in the theaters. IMAX, if you can. It's a definite experience. So that's it for this nasty review. Come back soon for more, and I'll see you later. Nuff said.